We will support the proposal by CIOC in Parliament to provide a mechanism in the referendum where Kenyans can vote on issues, not just a yes-no referendum. We have taken the position that there is room for us to improve this document further. And we have stated categorically and respectfully that it is never too late to do the right thing. The team foregoing, it is legitimate to question the wisdom of spending 14 billion shillings a year before an election that will cost us another 42 billion going by the 2017 figures of the IEBC when a referendum could be conducted as the seventh ballot in a general election at a virtually no cost.
So normally I take positions and I'm very clear about. But you see, I am deputy president today, and I have the interests of every Kenyan. There are people who support us, and they want a real choice to express themselves.
Suspense.
Kura ya maamuzi ya kusema tu ndio ama la. Bunge letu la Kenya tayari inatengeneza sheria ambayo itasimamia mambo ya referendum. Na hiyo sheria inapendekeza ya kwamba kuwe na kura katika articles ama vipengele tofauti.
Dreamers.
By providing a mechanism for Kenyans to vote on the issues.
A multiple choice referendum is clearly more appropriate and as provided for in the current bill before Parliament, the referendum bill by the COIC chair, Honorable Jeremiah Kioni. We feel we should take that route.
A system
will be delimited by IEBC, that we give a window to IEBC to vary slightly up to about 20%, because we agree with the original principle that there must be equality of representation. It's what is right. The people on the other side are reasonable people. They are also intelligent. That is why they took on board the suggestions that were made by stakeholders after Bomas, even after they said nothing will be changed. So they are reasonable and intelligent people, and they should be able to look at the merit of what we are saying.
From the number that is being proposed under the PPI arrangement, a minimum of 60 MPs will be slashed out by adopting the proposal we have made.
An increase under the MPs is untenable and a hugely unsustainable burden on the taxpayer.
The Deputy President and his...
procurement of personal protective equipment and other auxiliary commodities, and I rightfully directed them to KEMSA as our procurement agency.
Do you know Dr. Catherine Wanjiku?
Yes, sir, I know Dr. Wanjiku.
How do you know her?
I've worked with her. I've known her for more than 14, 15 years. I worked with her. She was my officer when I was a medical superintendent in Kiambu District Hospital.
You have no interest in Waleba's ventures?
No interest whatsoever. I'm not a director. I'm not a shareholder. No interest whatsoever.
Do you have interest in Rock's ventures too?
No interest. I don't even know that particular firm.
At any given time, did you have any conversation with the suspended director for you pushing these companies to be given commitment letters for them to supply COVID-19 equipment?
I had lots of conversation with the former CEO of KEMSA regarding the state of commodities, because it's a question that would arise each and every day during our press release. And I have even letters to that effect in terms of the communication I had with him, but I did not push for any specific company or individual to be given a tender.
You are not involved in the procurement part, but we want to know this communication, what did it accumulate to in terms of the stocks that KEMSA has?
Chair, the communication was just to be able to understand what stocks KEMSA had in place and the projections going forward of what would require. And KEMSA submitted that information to me. I have this information through an email communication from both the CEO and the commercial director of KEMSA. And that is when KEMSA was stating the stocks that they had in place. Regarding the amount of stocks that KEMSA procured, I never gave any directive to KEMSA, neither was I consulted on what the quantities that were procured.
The answer is, members of the two of you, Treasury and the Ministry of Health, to sit down these 2 days that are remaining, or three, or in the course of this week, and engage the stakeholders to avert the strike.
It was,
as far as I'm concerned, is unsatisfactory.
It's clear that we will not make any headway with such a narrative by the CEC, who definitely is not here to give the true account and to prosecute the issues that led to the strike.
A similar
that if we just give this money without the doctors actually having a structure where they will be taking calls, it will not be fair.
What you mean is the word call allowance. It was not given for calls for you to be called. When it was given to improve the take home for doctors working in health facilities.
The session
day morning, you will have no doctors, the strike will continue as per the advisory of the National Advisory Council of KMPDU until all these matters are resolved.
For embezzlement and abuse of resources intended for the mitigation of COVID-19 pandemic, we shall be on the watch to ensure that whatever resources are given to us to fight against COVID-19 are properly used.
Through as it is currently crafted, we will require interventions coming again from Exchequer to support us in terms of giving money to the students or giving loans to the students. In the first instance, the first proposal, it is estimated that we'll lose about 2 billion shillings, which means about 48,000 students will actually miss the funding.
Help say yet another showdown looms at City Hall. The Nairobi County Assembly members will be casting their votes in an attempt to impeach the governor, Mike Sonko. Just a day before that crucial vote, the governor and a section of MCAs are in Mombasa for an alleged holiday.
And he also asked
the governor through his spokesperson, Ben Mulwa, despite not denying his visit to Mombasa, argues that he has every right to meet his fellow leaders from the county assembly.
And if it
is developments, despite the Employment and Labor Relations Court through Justice Nzioki Makau pronounced itself on the matter on Monday, directing the county assembly not to proceed with the impeachment motion. Sonko now accuses the assembly members of defying the same constitution They're accusing the governor of not upholding OIFIN